is faithful women of God, serving with a new attitude. Amen. And I just was looking at this theme, and I was looking up the words, of course, as we do. Faithful means to be constant, loyal, and steadfast. And I'm sorry, let me back up a little bit. I give honor to the pastor in his absence. So our first lady, the first lady, Bell, first lady Lorianne Bell. She is my cousin as well, my big cousin. So I thank God for her, and I thank God for the position and how God has elevated her and Pastor Bell into the place of ministry. And I see and I hear, I may not be here physically in the building, but I hear and I can feel it in my spirit how God is just elevating you and taking you into the place. There's not a manual, there's not a book that teaches you how to be a first lady. Hallelujah. But you have to stay on your knees, and as you stay on your knees, God will elevate you and teach you how to be that first lady. So it's not easy. Y'all may see her and look at her sitting up there, but it's not an easy task. Amen? And I thank God for my husband being here with me. Thank God for my mother and my family. Just thank God for all the saints. Going back to the theme, faithful means to be constant, loyal, and steadfast. Another definition I looked at says strict or thorough in the performance of duty. A faithful worker. Serving means to give. Attitude is an expression of favor or disfavor toward a person, place, or thing. It's feeling. So I was looking at this, and we're talking about God in here. We're not just talking about anything, because we're talking about faithful women. Hallelujah, and being faithful to God. There's so many things that we can be faithful to, but we're talking about being faithful to God. And I looked at this, and I just was down here, and the Lord was just giving me to put these words together, and it says, because God has been so good to us. And I just broke down the definition. I will give him a constant expression of favor. Serve with a faithful attitude. Amen. Amen. And so I'm looking at this theme again, and as we're in the year of 2014, and as we heard the first lady talking about calling on the name of Jesus and how so many people are going through things, and it is so important in these days that we learn to be faithful to God. We can't go doing business as usual anymore, but it's time for us to knuckle down, because time is winding up. The game. It's so easy to come to church. We talk about it so many times. If you grew up in church, you know how to act like the saints. You know how to dance like them. You know how to shout like them. You know how to throw your hands up like them. But it's time for us to get past of having a form of godliness, but starting to get a true worship. Because what God requires of us is to have a relationship. And in order to have a relationship with him, you got to get to know him. So many times I talk about how naturally so you meet a guy or you meet a woman, and in order for you to get to know them, you got to spend time with them. And the same thing goes for God. In order for us in our relationship with him to get rooted and grounded, we got to spend time with him. Talking about faithful women. Amen. We got to spend time with him. We got to get down on our knees. We got to Ecclesiastes, the 9th chapter and the 10th verse. But I've just been reading this whole chapter, so we're going to go starting at the 3rd verse. And if you don't mind, I'm going to be reading out of the NIV, New International Version, so bear with me. This is the evil in everything that happens under the sun. The same destiny overtakes all. The hearts of men, moreover, are full of evil, and there is madness in their hearts while they live, and afterwards they join the dead. Anyone who is among the living has hope. Even a living dog is better off than a dead lion. For the living know that they will die, but the dead know nothing. They have no further reward, and even the memory of them is forgotten. Their love, their hate, and their jealousy have long since vanished. Never again will they have a part in anything that happens under the sun. Go eat your food and gladness. And drink your wine with a joyful heart. For it is now that God's favor, what you do, always be clothed in white, and always anoint your head with oil. Enjoy life with your wife, whom you love, all the days of this meaningless life that God has given you under the sun, all your meaningless days, for this is your lot in life, and in your toilsome labor under the sun. Whatever your hands find to do, do it with your might. In the grave where you are going, there is neither working nor planning, nor knowledge nor wisdom. I have seen something else under the sun. The race is not given to the swift, or the battle to the strong, nor does food come to the wise, or wealth to the brilliant, or favor to the learned, but time and chance happen to them all. May the Lord add a blessing to the reading and hearing of his word. Amen. So what they're talking about here in the Ecclesiastes, as it says, everything under the sun is meaningless. And the writer of Ecclesiastes is trying to get us to see is that everything on earth is meaningless. How much money we make, power, material things, what we have done or what we are doing, now it is all meaningless. If any man boasts over in Jeremiah, the 9th chapter, verses 23 through 24. If any man boasts, let him boast in the Lord. So he's letting us see when he's talking about these things on the earth is meaningless, because we know that these things shall perish. We know that these things will pass away. We know that one day we're going to die and we're going to leave here. But he's talking about these things are meaningless. And the thing that we have down here that we hold on to is our hope, which is our meaning in Christ. Amen? So we can't be caught up in the things of this earth. We can't be caught up in the things of this world, in this world, because they're meaningless. Amen? And in the 3rd verse, he talks about, he says, if you like the dog, this is the evil thing, and everything that happens under the sun, the same destiny overtakes all. The hearts of men, moreover, are full of evil, and there is madness in their hearts. While they live, and afterwards they join the dead. Anyone who is among the living has hope. Amen. So even if we have a spirit, just like a dog, just like a little dog, we still got hope. Amen. So look at your neighbor and say, I still got hope. Amen. We may not be doing everything right. We may not be doing everything that God has required of us to do, but if you're here today, if you still living, you got hope. Amen. Amen. When our breath is taken up people go for deliverance.
Right.
That's why I go to get my healing. That's why I go to meet God sometimes. That's not a place that you play. So when you come up here and come to the altar, like they sing the song sometimes, come to Jesus, you can't come up here playing.
Right. Go ahead.
When you make a vow to God and make a commitment to Him, that means you're coming.
Yes.
Didn't say that you're going to mess up. Didn't say that you're going to slip sometimes. But that means if I do mess up, I go out and ask Him. And His name is Jesus.
Yes.
And I repent to Him.
Hallelujah.
And ask Him for forgiveness. And when we ask for forgiveness, that means we turn from our evil and wicked ways. Not taking Him as a genie. I tell my daughter so many times, He's not a genie in a bottle. You can't just rub the bottle when you want Him or when you need Him. Against your brother, go to your brother.
Amen.
said, I thought you were getting smart with me on the text message. And I said, you know, I thought that same thing, but I had to pray. And I said, because you know why? I said, that's why I would tell you so often to call me. Because sometimes the message can be misinterpreted in the text message. We got so far from just text messaging each other. But if you heard my voice, you would have heard that I didn't have an attitude. You would have heard that I wasn't getting smart. And so sometimes it can be just a mere understanding. And when we got together, and I said, you still want to talk to me? She said, I prayed about it. I think it was just a miscommunication. And I said, yeah. We both talked about it. Sweet. obedient to God. Then, Lord, I'm going to do better.
Amen.
I'm not asking you to be the first lady. I'm not saying be the, you know, the church mother or anything like that. But your own commitment. You know where you stand with them.
Amen.
You know what you need to tighten up. Let's be real.
Amen.
You know what you need to tighten up. You know what you need to let go of. Because some things you just need to let go.
Amen.
The things that's holding us back, we need to let go. I remember a relationship that I was in, and I kept praying and hoping that it worked out. And the Lord kept saying to me, you can't be with him and serve me.
Amen.
And I kept thinking, Lord, well, why? You can't be with him and serve me. Because when we're unequally yoked,
right,
it holds us down. Let's just tell the truth about it. It holds us down because you can't wholeheartedly just pour out to God. You can't just completely give to him because you got this battle in your home. And so some things we have to just get rid of. We have to get rid of and let go. And so I was looking at this and it says, go eat your food with gladness and drink your wine with a joyful heart. For it is now that God's favor, what you do. And I was looking at the favor of God. When God's favor is up on you, it ain't fair. It may not look fair to everybody else. And I was just thinking about that. Sometimes it seems like the evil man is prospering. And it gets us stumbled up because we lose focus on who we should be keeping our eyes on. And his name is Jesus. The scripture says, I will look unto the hills from which cometh my help, because my help cometh from the Lord. For if I'm looking up to the hills from which cometh my help, I can't be distracted by the things that are going down here around me, because their eyes are fixed up here. And so I was looking, sometimes it don't look favorable. I mean, look good, it look like they're prospering, look like they're gaining, and you struggling, and you trying to make it, and Lord, I'm trying to live right, and I'm trying to do right, and it just seems like they just getting stuff like nothing. It's more than the world can even offer. It's more than any material thing. It's more than any power, any natural thing, when the favor of God is up on you. Because when the favor of God is up on you, when you go somewhere, he'll meet you there.
Yeah.
He'll open up doors that no man can close, and close doors that no man can open. That's the favor of God. When the favor, you have the favor of God, even when you're down to your last dollar, you don't know how the bills are going to get paid. The favor of God will send a check in the mail. Anoint your head with oil. I thought about it, I just became a this not even a week ago. And yesterday as I was studying, I've just been continually thinking about it. The grandbaby was laying in the bed and he made a little whimper and I went in to check on him. And I was in the midst of praising God. And so I went into the room and I was, hallelujah, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. And I looked over at his thing and he just got the biggest smile on his face. I mean, where he showed his gums and everything. And I said, that's right. Praise him. God is good. And so I looked at that even with a newborn baby, you know how to praise God. Lord, God is good. How about the saints that are able to walk and talk and speak?
Be faithful to God.
because we can't get up there and have breath. We can't get up there and have special, but this is God who can breath right here.
Amen. Amen. Yes.
Amen. Thank you, Lord.
Nothing you understood. When God calls you, sometimes we run from our callings and we want to hide. I tried it too and didn't think I was worthy enough and thought I had committed too much sin, but God chose me.
Amen.
And that's something that you should know. When you know that you have a relationship with God and you know without a shadow of a doubt that God chose you, you don't have to hang your head down.
Thank you, Lord.
You don't have to hang your head down anymore. You don't have to feel shame and you don't have to feel bad no more. You have given your life to Christ.